Starting to the bottom left of the map, we have the Startale player. He's down the map already. Can he force the third game? His idea is, of course,
Startale Ace.
We'll be going Forge Fast to expand this game, as his pylon placement indicates.
A very experienced player and one of the pillars of the Startale team. Starting to the top left, though, we have his opponent. He's a Kaspar player and his ideas.
Samsung전자 Kantloro.
I'm amazed actually by how fast he does that. I want to know how many takes he needed in order to pull this off.
When I listen to it, I feel like some sort of speed up program may have been used on the MP3.
Seriously. He probably cheated.
Maybe like 20% speed up, I think.
I think he can pull that off. It's Street Fighter voice after all.
Yeah, I guess so. By the way, just a little bit of probe harassment here in the main base, trying to deny the closer patch mining.
And also very important is that Ace was able to spot his opponent on the first position that he actually scouted. Therefore, he's forcing this spawning pool, of course. And at the same time, he now has the option of playing it a little bit more greedy than he was actually planning on doing.
Yeah. Ace, this is actually a great map for cannoning a natural. So if you ever see someone going hatch first and you go for the faster forge, you can very easily just get away with that if there's no overlord to spot. So that's something that is also a reason why a Zerg player might want to go pool first.
And this is also one of the maps where we have seen double hatch before pool for the first time. It was actually Hero up against Freaky. So something that we've seen now, Ace is really going for the Nexus first because he spotted his opponent on the first location that he scouted with his probe, and he knows exactly about the pool timing and everything else that the Zerg player is planning right now.
Ace not quite able to get the hatch block off there at the last second, but he denied it quite a bit. And these are just little things you can do as a Protoss when you scout your opponent first. It's so easy. He's going to go gate before cannon as he can go for the Nexus first. I mean, he's going to have a slightly faster Cybernetics Core. And the probe is just hanging around until the Lynx come out. He's going to want to draw the Lynx away from his base so he can get that cannon up. This is just pretty textbook play here. And a gas goes down, actually, for Roro as soon as the probe is chased out.
And Roro is already heading out with another drone, so he wants to take this third base as well. He gets gas, but he also goes for another hatchery at roughly 4 minutes and 10, 4 minutes and 20.
Yep. And the second probe comes out because this time he's going to want to be a little bit more careful about blocking potential links. And a Roachborn goes down. He actually wants to be aggressive early on here. It's a 4.5 minute Roachborn. This is very fast.
Exactly. It's a very fast Roachborn indeed. And he wants to be aggressive here. He's going... The one thing that I'm actually interested in, and I think he's going to skip it, will he get speed for the Zerglings for a speedling follow-up? With the timing that he has here, I actually doubt it. The early Roach Warren doesn't make a lot of sense if he doesn't want to immediately build Roaches as soon as he has.
You know, something else I'm thinking about is he only left one Ling to chase the probe. Usually you do two. Sometimes you just do one, but it's pretty rare. I think he wants him to see the third hatchery, but Ace is just not going to see it. He's actually just letting the probe go, essentially, here. He's like, all right, well, are you going to see my hatchery? Now Ace is trying to go around, and he does block it, but he didn't even click those Lings. Those Lings actually did that on their own. So Ace now actually may make additional cannons because he's not sure. We'll see. If he cuts corners here, he might find himself in trouble because six Roaches are already on the way.
And the Zerglings as well. He's playing it with slow Lings. He doesn't go for speed, but slow Lings at this time will definitely be able to do a lot of damage, and they might be able to catch up with the Roaches and just arrive there in time.
It makes it so that you can have more Roaches because you have that extra gas. It's only four extra Roaches, but that makes a big difference.
Yeah, that's actually a lot. And especially now that they're sneaking across the map. Without the speed, of course, the Zerglings not as effective against the Stalker, but the big deal is that there are actually no sentries right now. He's going for three additional gateways. He wants to be aggressive on his own, but he spotted the Roaches, but he might already be too late.
It may be.
The sentry started.
Yeah, he canceled the gateway. He needs to get the cannons up, but I don't think it's going to be possible. The Zealot is going to fall so quickly here. And all he has to do is target down the cannons. They're going to die before they're finished. The Lings are already in. Ace is in a lot of trouble here. He needs those cannons. The sentry's finished. He needs to get the Lings away from the cannons.
Oh, that's the first sentry. He started his first force field, but he needs the cannons indeed. He doesn't have the units.
He may actually get these cannons up. It's going to be so close. One Roach falls.
Wow.
Cannon is ready. He kills another couple of probes at the same time. The warp gate research is nearly done and his gates are ready. He will be able to warp in additional units. And just look at those Rogers trying to take down the sentries, doing a lot of damage here. The third Fororo, of course, has been cancelled. And the cannon, it dies. He's trying to take down another sentry, but where are the warp ins for Ace?
He needs to block those links from getting in again. He doesn't have energy on that sentry. The second one pops out and he blocks them. He needs those links out of his main. The problem is there are still roaches in the main base, three of them in fact. He's gonna have to pull his probes from there.
The harvest account 17 for Roro, 21 still for Ace. Ace trying to make this work. This
great
defense
block on
pulling
the ramp
off somehow. Now he has three cannons, but will it be enough? The roaches in the main base, they are all dead. The gates actually not transformed into gateways just yet.
Yeah, he can transform them, but he doesn't have the resources to use them. He's on autopilot here. He's starting up another sentry on his gateway that's dying. He needs to make this into warp gates, and finally he does.
Finally he does, but he might be a little bit too late. The core is being sniped.
He loses the core. He can't make any more sentries. He needs to make another one right now. He does two additional sentries. He's going to try to block them out. This is such a weird situation that we have here.
I think Ace was finally able to stabilize him, but at what cost?
He needs to block here, and he's a little bit late.
The cannons kill one of the roaches, but the other one is actually getting in. And now it's still 17 harvesters for Oro against 24 for Ace. Two base against two base. The cannons eliminate the last roach. That's the natural. Kills one additional pylon. Ace has lost so much already.
I think he should kill the neutral depot. If he kills the neutral depot, he can make a better wall here. But he's too afraid to let the cannons fire at anything but roaches for just a second.
Aurora is now going into macro mode.
Yeah.
He is building 10 additional drones. He knows that it's not possible for him to break through here. But at the same time, he knows that his opponent doesn't have a core anymore. That his opponent lost a lot of his harvesters. And with the overlord sight on the high ground, he actually snipes the pylon and supply blocks it.
He supply blocks him and unpowers the gateways. He can even take out these gateways. There's not enough high ground units. As you mentioned, he knows there's no core, so he can't make stalkers. There's not going to be any stalkers to pick off these roaches. Roar, I feel, despite the fact that he was down in harvesters temporarily, I think is way ahead here. How many resources Ace had to spend on all these cannons that he made and how many cannons he lost?
He lost 2,800 resources, 1,000 more than Roro and the Zerg player now being on two bases. But one thing that we should still mention is that there is actually a pylon to the top middle of the map where he could potentially warp in units. And he's going for three additional gates, which will put him up at four.
And he's not making probes. I think he's just going to try to hit a timing after this. But, Keller, I just don't think it's going to work. He doesn't have the production he needs to actually make an attack that can be sustained. He will get a few warp ins off, maybe two, and then if Roro holds at that moment, he won't have anything else to buy.
Speed, of course, also being researched, and this is going to be a big issue for Ace if Roro starts to build more Zerglings and then chases down Stalkers, for example. Five gates are building. This will put him up at six gates. He just tries to take his opponent down with a pylon at the top, and he might be able to pull it off, but Roro is playing it really safe. He's even getting two spine crawlers already and transitioning straight into his fire.
Yeah, while taking a hidden base to the right side of the map with a drone as well. This is so cool because this is a style that will basically hard counter what Ace is doing if he holds the initial wave, because then he's going to have the mobility, he's going to have the hidden base. Ace tries to attack the hidden base, the Muses fly into his base. Ace has not lost this yet, but this is going to be so difficult to make work.
This opening was definitely great for Oro. The base, the hidden base, not built yet, but there's a potential of doing it with the drone that he sent down to the bottom right. Here comes the first Zealot having a poke here, but those two spine crawlers, of course, take him down easily.
Yeah, and this is exactly what Ace wanted to see. He wanted to see, is this even reasonable for me, or should I start thinking of a backup plan? Does he have spines? And now, as soon as the Zealot was shown, Roro knows exactly what's going on. Where did that Zealot come from? Of course there's a forward pylon somewhere. I gotta send my units back, I gotta get into defense mode here.
But you know, also one of the things that we should consider here is that Roro doesn't have a third base, so he is still making this work with a two-base saturation. And of course, Ace not having blink is going to be an issue, but how much will Mutalisk actually help him here? The Spinecrawler is a big deal, especially since there are so many, but it's going to be very, very difficult for Oro to take a third base now.
Yeah, he's got that hidden drone on the right side of the map, but he hasn't made a hatchet with it yet.
And even if he does, the saturation is going to be very slow.
Yeah, very slow indeed. Sentries are going to get picked off here. But he tries, and he actually will catch a few roaches as a result.
Nice target here. Takes on 1, 2, 3, 4 sentries. Really, really well done. The question is, what is Roro going to do with those 10 meterless that he's building? Will he try to defend, or does he actually say, well, I'm safe enough, let's just take down his economy?
You know, I feel he is safe enough. He's actually rallied the mutas across, and he's going to send them. There's no way that Ace can actually break through these spines. There's too many. There's 10 spine crawlers here. He doesn't even have plus one for his Protoss units.
And here are the Mutalists. Two of them already sent into the mineral line at the natural. I think actually he should have waited for the rest of them and do more damage. He can't fly into those cannons, of course. And here is Ace trying to commit. He knows that this is his only shot. But with all those spine crawlers, it's just not going to work.
It's never going to work. The Roaches take out the Zealots. Even the Queen remains alive. It falls finally. The drones are here. There's nothing left to do. I mean, the Mutas are trying to find probes to kill at the National, but there's very few left.
Wolf, there is 13 of them left, 10 now, that's all he's got. 33 probes were killed over the course of this game, and Ace is now losing his army as well. He's dropping down to 20 supply, and this is it. Roro is going to take this game with a 2-0.
And he will.
And he made it look easy.
He certainly did. Ace is going to fall apart here. I don't know what that force field was, but he's not getting up the ramp. He locks himself out.
The third base not needed for Roro. GG.
Pretty straightforward defenses by Roro here.
Yeah, really, really well played. A job well done by Roro, and a very aggressive strategy that paid off for him. Ace is out of Code A. Not too happy about this, of course.
No, he's totally out. He's been out before, but you know, this guy, when he disappeared last time, was able to come back, came into Code S, and everyone was talking about him. Now he's all the way out, and it just goes to show that if you consistently make you consistently fail to win your best of threes, win your groups, you will be as out as soon as you came back in.
And once again, just once again, this problem that Ace has with Zergs these days, it's so weird to actually observe this, that it's historically speaking his best matchup. A 58% win ratio against Zerg. But just in the last 2-3 months against this race, he was really struggling so much. And now he is out of Code A because of it. He's down to Code B once again. But Roro, we talked about his performance at WCS Korea against Protoss, but this just showed once again that he is one of the major competitors in this Code A season.
Yeah, he certainly is looking great. This guy is the guy everyone was talking about. He just has these little things in his play. He scouts and he reacts, but he does it better than most people are doing it right now, I feel like. Like, for example, in the game where he saw the Twilight Council only, we mentioned earlier, he didn't notice the plus one. He wasn't sure about that. Made Spore Crawlers even. Then he made a ton of Lings, and he was just very cautious.
Yep.
Then when he had the extra units, he used them well. That was on game one. Then on game two, he did an all-in strategy, but executed it well. Really nice micro. And then just little things like, all right, I'm done here, but I'm still going to get your gateway and kill your pylon. Just little things like that, abusing everything that you see about your opponent. And Ace just was not prepared for the defense. And when he did try to defend, he got put into a position where it was awkward. Didn't know what to do. We're going to have a 5-minute break, guys. We'll be back with some more Code A action.